turn her word to theirs, singing the story of her life, the struggles and triumphs of growing up hard in the inner city.
What have you learned about yourself that you didn't know before?
I learned that I'm stronger than what I thought I was. And I learned that I am beautiful inside and out.
She writes most of her own songs and makes her style accessible to people who don't normally listen to rap and urban music, the number one sound among young people today. Mary J. Blige has become to her generation what Billie Holiday, Aretha Franklin, and Tina Turner were to theirs, singing the story of her life, the struggles and triumphs of growing up hard in the inner city, making music that touches fans from the ghetto streets to Main Street, as she did at the Grammy Awards last year, where, in a breakout moment, she dazzled the mainstream audience with her signature song, No More Drama.
I don't know, only God knows where the story ends for me, but I know where the story begins. It's up to us to choose whether we win or lose, and I choose to win.
You put your life into your song. Mm-hmm. What makes a Mary J. song?
I always want to be a messenger, a person that, you know, just that's not afraid to pass on wisdom. I got to give them something other than some little stupid record. You know, I want them to dance, but I want them to also know that there's something in there for you. It's a gift in there. It's a hidden message in there, but it's a beautiful hidden message. It's not no kill your parents. It's let's get free.
Peace of mind. Well, I need a good night's sleep. Please step your free.
When Blige talks about getting free, she means letting go of the insecurity, abuse, betrayal, and self-destructiveness she grew up with in the thug-dominated culture of the projects. And when she sings, she touches a nerve in her fans. Fans that at first were young, black, and urban, but today are all races and all ages.
How many real heads in New York we got tonight?
Mary J. Blige grew up in poverty in the drug and crime-infested projects of Yonkers, the New York City suburb where she lived with her mother and sister after her father abandoned the family.
You saw a lot of violence when you grew up.
Mm-hmm.
Did it frighten you?
It kind of like put us in shock because we used to just stand there and look at it like, wow. But then you see your mom get hit. And then it's like, ugh! Like you just go, used to start screaming and crying. And you see your mother get hit.
By men in her life.
Yeah. And you know, men just seem like they didn't have any mercy. They hit you like you are a man. Like I've seen women get their heads punched through walls as a kid.
But it wasn't just violence against her mother.
You sing about things that are really personal, like being molested as you were 4 or 5 years old?
Five.
I want to tell you a story about a little girl. She was 4 years old when her father walked out the door, and when she ran into her deadbeat dad, you know what she said to him? Where were you when they was touching all over your baby girl? They were touching my body, touching my body.
For a long time, that's something that I was hiding. For a long time, that's something that made me do drugs and drink. Mm-hmm. And as an artist, I had to share it.
If you came out tonight to have a good time with Mary J. Blige, let me hear you scream.
Her concerts are a combination of revival meeting and hip-hop opera. She preaches, cajoles, and struts through songs that chart the ups and downs of her life and express her many different moods.
How do you reconcile the differences that I see in you and that others see in you? Sometimes you're very warm, sometimes you're cold, sometimes you're very vulnerable and open, and sometimes very closed. How do you put those things together?
A lot of it comes from when I grew up. My mother was the man and the woman. She had to be the lady, and she had to be, you know, the protector and the provider. So I carry a lot of that still.
I'm going down. I'm going down.
Music was Blige's escape from the dysfunction all around her.
My whole world
Mary J. started singing in school talent contests when she was just 7. By 17, she had a recording contract. Her first CD, What's the 411, in 1992 spawned 5 top 10 singles and a new musical genre, hip-hop soul. Blige was the original ghetto fabulous, part goddess, part street tough, a fashion style that would become widely imitated. Her next 2 CDs went platinum, but she describes them as cries of pain as her life unraveled. She says she lost her voice, money, and dignity, not only because of her abusive relationships with men, but also because of her increasing drug use. She was, she says, her own worst enemy.
You start drawing to you what you are on the inside, insecure, jealous, mad, and you start drawing these men that are like that, and they start whipping on you.
Even though she bore the bruises, Mary J. couldn't face the truth about the men in her life.
You know, it's scary when they tell you who they are. Mm-hmm. Because it's someone that you probably always suspected, but no, they love me. But they really didn't love you.
So men you went out with physically abused you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I don't blame them because I allowed it.
But how can you not blame them? They beat you.
Mm-hmm.
That's not your fault.
It's not my fault, but the only way that I could get out is to stop being a victim. I had to stop saying, you did it. You. It's because of you. I had to sit down and say, you know what? Something is wrong here because every man that I get is doing the same exact thing to me. So maybe it's something wrong with me.
Taking responsibility for yourself is one of Blige's strongest messages. Self-acceptance is another. Her newfound faith in herself, she says, is part of her renewed faith in God.
If I don't accept the scar on my face, the lips that God gave me, the big giant feet, whatever, the long legs, whatever it is that I'm deformed with, I gotta love it so everybody else can love it. Loving it. Then it turned into vanity. that's the tricky part. It could turn into...
And when it turned into vanity?
I had to use a substance to keep me feeling sexy. I had to use alcohol, keep my mind off of the fact that somewhere deep inside of me, I was still ugly.
So you drank a lot?
I drank a lot.
And used cocaine?
I was buying boulders of it, chopping it up, staying up all night long, go to sleep, wake up, try to do it again, then do it again, then do it again. And it was all to keep my mind off of my insecurities.
And since you've been straight, since you've been sober, what have you learned about yourself that you didn't know before?
I learned that I'm stronger than what I thought I was. And I learned that I am beautiful inside and out.
At 32, Mary J. Blige is hitting her stride. Here shooting a video for her latest CD, Love and Life, which hit the charts at number 1 this fall and has already gone platinum. Blige now has a total of 6 platinum CDs, 17 top 10 singles, and 2 Grammys. Despite a new take charge attitude towards managing her career, Mary J. is still paying the tab for her past. She dropped out of school in the 11th grade and reads at only an 8th grade level.
It hurts a lot when you cannot really comprehend what a person is saying in a meeting, or you don't even understand what you're reading in your contract.
How do you deal with that today?
I ask questions. Like, I used to be ashamed. I used to be like, too much pride. You know, I ain't asked nobody nothing because I don't want nobody to think I'm stupid. So I just drop my pride and say, you know what? I don't understand what you just said. Could you explain it to me? And I find myself learning more.
Blige is also learning how to work again with her first producer, Sean Puffy Combs, whom she met when they were both unknowns, and he produced her first 2 critically acclaimed CDs. After a falling out that lasted 5 years, they reunited and he produced Blige's latest CD. She says he's like a brother.
Our chemistry is a Puff knows, baby, what's gonna make people dance. I know what's gonna make people cry.
In the recording studio, Blige is a perfectionist.
Why are you ignoring me? I had...
She says songwriting comes naturally, but Puffy helps refine what she writes.
Still, it sounds right. I mean, go try it.
The pain is so much sometimes, it makes me sit up all night.
I can see music. I know what it looks like. I know what color it is. The words come easy, the tears come easy, and the joy comes easy. The music tells you what to do.
Why you wanna make me cry? Hurt so bad. For you to give me reasons I should leave you, babe. Need you, babe. Don't wanna leave you, babe.
In the studio or out on stage, Mary J. doesn't just sing her songs, she lives them, burying her soul even about something as personal as premenstrual syndrome.
PMS. I was listening to PMS, mm-hmm. Not a topic you hear people sing about in popular music. It was a wonderful song.
Thanks.
But it's the last thing I expected to find on a CD.
Well, I mean...
But it works.
When you PMSing, you can look in the mirror and see a monster. You can look in the mirror and say, I'm so ugly! I'm so fat! And so, yeah! So,
life has smoothed out since she met Kendu Isaacs, a music producer, who is now her fiancé. She says it was Isaacs who reconnected her to her Christian faith and prompted her to get clean and sober and stay that way, threatening to leave if she didn't.
He's not afraid of me. He's not intimidated by me. He's very confident. And I think that's one of the reasons why I'm still with him.
Blige and Isaacs live in a big house in New Jersey, just across the river from the projects, but a world away from where she grew up.
Someone said the trick to being a star is having the talent to handle one's talent. You think you're at that point now?
I have the strength. You know, I mean, I have everything. I'm equipped. When you finally understand who you are, ages 6 through 60, will understand who you are. Because when they see a person that's come through all that I've come through, still standing, it's amazing.
No more drama, everybody. I know that we are not invincible, but can we at least make a positive confession over our life and say no more, say no more, say no more, say no more, no more, no more.